I'm very pleased to do so.
Although the London Regional Passengers Committee normally criticises British Rail, it likes occasionally to swap the brickbats for bouquets. Hence this new award. The committee members became the Egon Rones of the transport world as they inspected 15 London termini, determined to search out the best-kept station. But they found that standards are patchy.
The kind of thing you find is that things like lavatories are not kept as well as they should be, or that there's a lot of litter about. Information's very important, of course, that information isn't as forthcoming, staff maybe aren't quite as courteous as they should be, and so on.
None of that applies to the winning station. Waterloo owes much of its success to its dedicated team of three cleaners, who work night and day clearing up after an untidy public.
The worst times is on a Saturday when the football people are around there, you know, their cans of beer and their food and whatever, they just stick it on the floor. They got no respect for it, it seems to me, for cleanliness of the place, you know. But during the weekday, during the commuters coming off the trains and going home again, it's not too bad.
Actually, I haven't been to Waterloo for a number of years and I was very surprised at how neat and tidy it looked. I remember it's been very grubby.
I do like Waterloo, it's bright and light.
Well, I certainly think there's been a tremendous improvement at Waterloo Station over the past 10 years. In fact, it's a night and day situation.
Holborn Viaduct and Cannon Street were joint runners-up behind Waterloo. Now, London's top three stations go forward to a national competition to find Britain's best-kept station. Gail Goodwin at Waterloo for Thames News.